Hi everyone. Today, in this lesson, we are going to deal with electrostatics of conductors. So maybe you have learned already about the conductors and insulators in previous classes. So here we are dealing with the conductors in electrostatic condition. So let's discuss about what is meant by conductor. So conductor means the substance which allow large scale physical movement of electric charges through them when an external electric field is applied. So when an external electric field is applied, there is a physical movement of electric charges. So what is the physical movement of electric charges? Here we are mainly dealing with the charge carriers are free electrons. In order to understand the free electron concept, just think about the structure of an atom. As you already know, the structure of atom means what? The central portion, you already know what that is called, what? Nucleus. So nucleus, as you already know, the mainly it is what? Positive charge. And around the nucleus, as you already know, there are electrons are orbiting. Around the nucleus, electrons are orbiting in an orbit. Maybe there are many orbits will be there. Now you just think about all these electrons are bound to the nucleus except one, which is that one, the outermost shell. The outermost shell or the outermost orbit electrons are not that much bound to the nucleus, and that electrons are called what? Valence electron. Valence electrons can free to move along the surface or free to move in the conductor, but it could not come out of the conductor. So this is the condition we are dealing with. Mainly the charge carriers are free electrons. Now you can see here the bound electrons as well as the nucleus is act as a positive ion. So the bound electron except the valence electron and the nucleus is mainly act as a positively charged ion, and the valence electron is considered as the reason for the conduction. Or here we are talking about in electrostatic condition, the movement of electrons in the external electric field. Now you just think about a few points regarding the conductors. In metallic conductors, charge carriers are free electrons, as you already know now. In metal, outer electrons are free to move, and that is called what? Valence electron. That is called free charge carriers, and it could not leave the surface. Third one, while they are moving, they collide with each other and with the ions and move randomly. Next point, the ions means nucleus and the bound electrons. Just now we have discussed here. And movement of electron is affected by electric field and chemical forces. So we are not dealing with the chemical forces now. Here we are dealing with the movement of electron while there is an external electric field is applied. Now let's discuss about a few important points regarding the electrostatics of conductors. The first one is that inside a conductor, electrostatic field is zero. Inside a conductor, electrostatic field is zero. Just imagine there is one plate. It's not a line, just a one plate. And this is another plate, two parallel plates. Just imagine the first plate is charged positively. First plate is charged positively. And the second plate is charged negatively. Okay. This is just for producing the electric field. Not necessary to draw the plate here. But in order to understand this one, there is a uniform electric field is applied from positive to negative. In between this positive charged plate and negative charged plate, you are placing a conductor. Electric field will be moving from positive to negative. Positive to negative. There will be many lines will be there. You can see here, there will be many lines from positive to negative. While this electric field is applied, you can see here this electric field is moving from positive to negative. What is there inside the conductor? Now this conductor is neutral, right? Now when the external electric field is applied, what will happen to the charge carriers inside the conductor? As you already know, due to this external electric field, so the electric field external direction is what? From first plate to second plate, which is written the electric field external. Due to this external electric field inside the conductor, electrons will move towards this left side of this conductor. That means you can see here, negatively charged electrons will be accumulated in the left side of the conductor due to external electric field is applied here. That is positive to negative. While these electrons are moving towards left side, what will be accumulated in the other side? There will be positive charges will be accumulated. Okay. Positively charges will be accumulated here. This process will continue. This process will continue. Now you can see here, inside this plate, there is an other electric field is acting from positive to negative. As you already know, electric field direction is from positive to negative. So inside the conductor, the electric field is, we can note it down as induced electric field. What is that? Induced electric field. Now you can see here, this charge accumulation continue till the external electric field and induced electric field become equal. Now what is the net electric field inside the conductor? What is the net electric field inside the conductor? You can write here, E net is equal to, E net is equal to summation, that is E external plus E induced. E external plus E induced. But E external is towards the right side, where E induced towards the left side. So you can write the E net is equal to E external minus E induced. So what is a net electric field inside the conductor? Zero. Net electric field inside the conductor is equal to what? Zero. So this is the first point regarding the electrostatics of conductors. So what is the first one? Inside a conductor, electrostatic field is zero in the presence of an external electric field. Now look at the second case. At the surface of a charged conductor, electrostatic field is normal to the surface at every point. What is the meaning here? Imagine surface of a conductor. Just imagine the electric field will be always normal. That we have already learned here. The electric field will be always normal to the surface. But in this case, we are considering the electric field is not normal. So this is the case we are dealing with. If the electric field is not normal, say this is electric field. Actually, the electric field must act normal to the surface, right? If this electric field is not normal, you can say here, there will be a component which will act along tangentially. This tangential component causes the free electrons move along the surface of the conductor. That means it becomes a surface current. And we are dealing with what? Electrostatic condition. The charges should not flow here. So this case, at the surface of a charged conductor, electrostatic field is always normal to the surface at every point. It should be normal. So there should not be any tangential component. Clear? Now look at the third case here. The net charge in the interior of the conductor is zero. So we have already learned that one. Net field inside is zero, right? And any excess charge resides at the surface. So let's prove that one. Imagine a conductor. This colored one is a conductor. An excess charge is given. That is, the positive charges are shown in the diagram is the excess charge given. And as you already know one conclusion here, the electric field inside the conductor is equal to zero. Use the Gauss theorem, phi is equal to q divided by epsilon zero, where phi is equal to E into area. E into area. Now look at the first case here. Inside this conductor, electric field is equal to zero. So if you consider a Gaussian surface here, you can consider a Gaussian surface anywhere. It is already shown here the Gaussian surface. This is a Gaussian surface. So I am just drawing again another Gaussian surface. So inside this Gaussian surface, there is no charge reside. That is what we are going to prove now here. Here electric field is equal to zero. So you can write here phi is equal to zero. If phi is equal to zero, first formula q divided by epsilon zero is equal to zero. So what is the charge resides here? Q is equal to zero. So this is the third point regarding the conductor. What is that? The net charge in the interior of a conductor is zero. And any excess charge resides only at the surface. So this is the third case. Now look at the fourth point. Potential is constant within and on the surface of a conductor. You just imagine a conductor, a conducting surface. If some extra charges resides on the surface, the previous case we have already know that one. What is electric field inside? Electric field inside is equal to zero. So what is the relation between electric field and electric potential? You learned that one, right? Electric field E is equal to minus dV divided by dr. dV divided by dr. Look at the inside case. What is electric field? E is equal to zero. So you can write here dV divided by dr minus dV divided by dr is equal to zero. Or we can write the dV by dr is equal to zero. The meaning of this one is here V is equal to constant. V is equal to constant. So the electric potential is constant everywhere inside as well as on the surface of the conductor. So this is the fourth point talking about potential is constant within and on the surface of a conductor. Now look at the fifth case here. Electric field at the surface of a charged conductor is proportional to the surface charge density. So as you already learned that one, what is the surface charge density? Surface charge density sigma is equal to charge per area. You have learned in the previous lessons. So you need to explain this one. You just imagine a conducting surface. So here the diagram shown here a conducting surface. Just imagine on this conductor there are many charges are distributed. There are many charges are distributed here. Okay, everywhere on the surface there are many charges are there. And you just imagine the surface charge density is sigma. Surface charge density is sigma. And as you already know, inside the conductor, just imagine inside the conductor, electric field is equal to zero. So there is no flux inside the conductor. So in order to find the electric field just on the surface or just above the surface, just to consider a pill box. A pill box means a short cylinder. The short cylinder you will be placing in such a way that a small portion is inside the conductor and very small portion is outside the conductor. So just imagine this picture is too small here. I mean the cylinder is too small and that is called what? Pill box. So here this one, this cylinder is some partly inside and partly outside. But inside, if you consider everywhere electric field is equal to zero, so there is no flux will come out. That means the flux will be there only on the outer surface, the above surface you can see here. So this is the only way the flux can come out. So in this area on the surface, in this area on this surface, there also there are many positive charges are distributed, right? So what is the surface charge density here? Sigma. Here the area is too small, say it as delta S. So using formula, flux formula, phi is equal to q divided by epsilon 0, or flux phi is equal to E dot delta S, or we can say here the direction of electric field is also in the same direction, so you can directly write the E delta S is equal to phi. So E delta S is equal to q divided by epsilon 0. Now here, what is the q? So in this small area, what is the q? So in order to find the q here, you have already know this equation. Sigma is equal to q divided by area. So again, sigma is equal to charge per area. Which area is required here? This small area, what we have considered here as short cylinder, right? So this much area is only required. So that is same as delta S. So sigma is equal to q divided by delta S. Or q is equal to sigma into delta S. So you can substitute here E delta S is equal to sigma delta S divided by epsilon naught. Delta S cancel. So what is the final equation here? E is equal to sigma divided by epsilon 0. That means the electric field above the surface or just on the surface, E is equal to sigma divided by epsilon 0. If you write in vector notation, you can write the E is equal to sigma divided by epsilon 0 into a unit vector. What is the direction of unit vector here? So this is positive charges are distributed. So what is the direction of electric field? Outward normal. If it is negative charge, it becomes inward. That also normal to the surface. So this is the fifth case. Electric field at the surface of a charged conductor is proportional to surface charge density. You can see here E is directly proportional to sigma. So this is the fifth case. Look at the last case. What did the last case is talking about? Electric field is zero in the cavity of a hollow charged conductor. So now you can see the picture here. They say given there a conductor. Inside the conductor, at the midpoint of the conductor, you can see the white color. That is a cavity. That means there is no conducting part is there. So we have to prove that in that point, electric field is equal to zero. In order to prove that, what is the first case? We should consider a Gaussian surface. In the picture, it is already marked here, a Gaussian surface, which is very close to this cavity. So once again, we'll be writing here, what is the flux formula? Flux phi is equal to, flux phi is equal to q divided by epsilon 0. Q divided by epsilon 0. Or flux phi is equal to E into area. E into area. Now you can see here, all the charges are resides only at the surface, not inside in a conductor, right? So we have already learned that one. So you can see here, the Q is equal to zero. Inside this one, inside this Gaussian surface, the net charge is equal to zero. So EA is equal to q by epsilon 0, where q is equal to 0. So what is E is equal to? E is equal to 0. Electric field is equal to 0. If the electric field is 0, it doesn't mean that there is no potential. No. Relation we have already learned. E is equal to what? Minus dV by dr. If electric field is 0, it doesn't mean that potential is not present, so we can write the dv by dr is equal to 0. It means that what, potential is constant. So you can see here in the picture, here the potential is constant everywhere in this cavity, as well as till the surface the potential is also constant. So potential will change only outside, the potential inside the conductor and inside this cavity will be a constant value. So this is the last case you are dealing with. Electric field is zero in the cavity of a hollow charged conductor. So this is one of the important application here. Inside a cavity, net charge resides equal to zero. That means electric field is equal to zero. That means the potential is constant. Potential is constant. The sixth point, now it is clear. This application, we are dealing in electrostatic shielding. So now let's discuss about what is the electrostatic shielding. Now, just before discussing about the electrostatic shielding, let's think about one example. During the lightning time, is it better to stand below a tree or better sit inside a car, which is suitable? If you say it's better to stand under a tree, what may happen there? Definitely you will get electrocuted, you will get electric shock. That means the charges will flow through your body and you will be electrocuted. So that is not a good way. Now you just think about, if you are sitting inside a car, imagine a lightning comes and strike on the car. As you already know, car body is a metallic body. When this lightning strike on the car, what will happen there? As you already learned, where the charges will be distributed, or always the charges will be distributed on the surface or resides on the surface. If the charges resides on the surface, so the last case we have discussed, the what is the electric field inside? Electric field inside is equal to zero. If the electric field inside is equal to zero, what is the potential inside the car? It is constant. The current will flow through our body when there is a potential difference inside the car. But here there is no potential difference. So what may not happen here? That we won't get electric shock in most of the cases. So this is one of the example for electrostatic shielding. So once again, let me tell you here, when the lightning strikes on the car, the charges will be distributed only on the surface of the car. So using Gauss's theorem, we have already learned last case, flux phi is equal to q by epsilon 0, and there is no charge inside this conductor, hollow conductor, right? This is a hollow conductor. Just note that point here. Hollow conductor. Inside it is hollow. And electric field is equal to zero. And potential is equal to what? Constant. And this hollow conductor is actually called Faraday's cage. Faraday's cage. Actually, it is a protecting cover. We will be protected from the lightning, and this is called what? An electrostatic shielding. So just discuss about the definition for that. Electrostatic shielding is the phenomena of protecting a certain region of space from external electric field. So definitely you can see here, from the external electric field it is protected. Inside the car, the electric field is equal to zero. So now you just imagine a hollow conductor. So this is a hollow conductor. Inside, as you already know, electric field is equal to zero. So potential is equal to a constant here. Potential is equal to constant. Just imagine this hollow conductor is placed in a external electric field. Definitely you can say that electric field will be there outside, and inside this conductor and mainly the hollow region, electric field will be zero. That means if you have a very sensitive instrument which may damage due to external electric field, you can protect this instrument by keeping it inside this hollow area, this hollow place. And that is called what? Faraday's cage. Why? What is the main use of keeping this instrument inside this hollow region? Because that region is electric field is not present. Our potential is constant. So, and that electric field is equal to zero, and that region called free from external field is called what? Electrostatic shielding. Okay. Hope you understand this one.